Hello boys, I Dr. Pradeep Kumar Srivastava, welcoming to all of you in my water resources engineering class. And today's topic is the distribution of canal water. Dear boys, in this topic, first we will discuss what is means of distribution of canal water. What is the need of distribution? My dear boy, when you are constructing a dam, and after that, one thing it is, remember, you are constructing a dam for storage of water, not irrigation. Okay, dam is generally not used for irrigation purpose. Then you will ask me, so how we will do irrigation? My dear boy, after the downstream, we are making an arrangement to diversion system. Think that this is the reservoir. What is this? Is the reservoir. You have stored the water in this. Now, how you will use the water? But this is a large quantity of water. And I think, in the huge water, you cannot regulate with a simple way. You cannot regulate in the simple way. So, my dear boy, you have constructed a system on the downstream of the river and downstream of the dam. Okay? And that system name is diversion. He will divert the water from here and he will divert the water from here. So it is the process of technical. Okay. Just you have keep in your house a big food storage. So a small quantum of material, foods you have stored in the small packet and then you are using. Like that, it is the system is same. So, it is the process distribution of canal water. Now, t- This is the distribution of canal water. So let us start. Now we will discuss the objective of distribution of canal water. A canal is an artificial channel, and that is constructed to carry water to the field. Listen this word. A canal is an artificial channel, and that is constructed to carry water to the field. To perform irrigation, and the water is taken either from the river, tank, or reservoir. Reservoir means, what is the reservoir means? Where you have collected all the river water in the one place. That is called reservoir. Reservoir. Actually, this is the German word. Reserve water. So I have said the reservoir. The water is taken either from the river, tank or reservoir, and the canal can be constructed either by means of concrete stone, brick, or any sort of flexible membrane which solve the durability issue like seepage and erosion. The distribution system is a canal. Irrigation system, canal, alignment, curve, and certain feature of the canal irrigation are briefly explained in this article. Okay, my dear boy, so we will read briefly. Canal or waterway. Channel or artificial waterway for water conveyance or to service water transport vehicle. They may also help with irrigation, and it can be thought of as an artificial version of a river. Canal carry free surface flow under atmospheric pressure. Canal carry free surface and flow under atmospheric pressure. In most cases, the engineered work will have a series of dam and lock that create reservoir of low speed current flow. This reservoir are referred to as a slack water level, often just called a level. A canal is also known as navigation, and when it is a parallel river and shear part of the water and drainage basin and leverages its resources by building dam, locks to increase and lengthen is structures of the slack water level and why staying in the valley. In contrast, a canal cut across the drainage. In contrast, a canal cut across a drainage, divide a top, a ridge, and generally requiring at the external water sources about the height elevation. Think that, my dear boy, this is the river . This is your dam. This is your diversion system. And when a water divert to like this, it is run almost to the river's town of the gravity. Like this entire all area down of beauty, and this is here. Okay. Clear? So, my dear boy, an external water hose, even the highest elevation, many canals have been built at elevation and touring over valley and other waterways crossing far below. Canal with sources of water at a higher level can deliver water to destination and such as the city where water is needed. The Roman Empire aqueduct were such water supply of the canal. Now, a canal is an artificial channel. It is not a nature-made channel. It is man-made channel. Canal is an artificial channel, generally trapezoidal, in the shape of constructed on the ground to carry water to the field and either from the river or form of the river. Now, just I will clear. Why trapezoidal channel? Actually, now, in the shape of pressure, why trapezoidal? The question is very important, and you should keep in your mind, why trapezoidal? My dear boy, because it has pressure of the water on this. And the same, it is a section of the this flowing of water channel. If it erode or not, but trapezoidal, why? Because have you seen the mountain? You see, the total science has copied from there. The trapezoidal pressure is fully and this fully made the pressure of water is at this point is zero. And this area is fully safe and no pressure of this. So, my dear boy, a canal is an artificial channel, generally topographical, in shape, constructed on the ground to carry and water to the field, either from the river or from a reservoir. So why trapezoidical? I think you have understood. Because every pressure of water, every pressure of water, it has B, G, it has being converted to the zero pressure and the area of this is only pressurized. And this area and this area, sorry, and this area is free from pressure. This area is free from pressure. So this is the use of trapezoidical. Correct? Any doubt? So a canal, an artificial channel, generally trapezoidical and shape, constructed on the ground to carry water to the field, either from the river or from a reservoir. This is the, my dear boy, classification of canal. So then, what is the classification? Classification based on the nature of source of supply. Up, as per classification and as per supply, there is two types of canal. Permanent canal and inundation canal. Classification based on the financial output. Classification based on the financial output. Productive canal or productive canal. Productive or productive. Okay. Now, classification based on the function of canal. Now we have come on our point. Irrigation canal, carrier canal, feeder canal, navigation canal, and power canal. So we will discuss independently. What is irrigation canal? My dear boy, which water is supplying the water to the irrigation field for irrigate the crop? That is the irrigation canal. And next, carrier canal. Have you seen boating? one thing. Carrier, there is a large difference. Anybody can say, then what? Then I will be use irrigation canal as a carrier canal? No. It is not possible. Why? Because, my dear boy, if bed of irrigation canal is this, when carrier canal bed is this, this is the major difference. And when slope is more, then gravity will be more. Naturally, because his, when slope is more, his velocity is more. Because he has get velocity from slope. Suppose you are, suppose this is a mountain and you are going to town the market. Sorry. You are going to down from the mountain, top of mountain. Do you feel very easy? I am coming fast off here. Here. Off here. Off here. Why? Because due to high slope. Due to high slope, you are going fast. You are going fast. Okay. Now, this is the main difference between irrigation canal and carrier canal. Now, feeder canal. Of what is a feeder canal, my dear boy? Suppose there is a basin. What is the basin? Suppose there is a basin. One river is coming from this area. One river is coming from this area. Okay. So you see that if he's in this basin, if rainfall will be dropped, it may be go left or right. So this is called basin. Now, if this basin is got heavy water and it is not huge for the farmer, so you can transfer of it water to this land. Okay. So this is the feeder canal. Correct? Clear? What is the feeder canal? One from one basin to next basin, which canal is feeding. That is the feeder canal. Now, next is navigation canal. A navigation canal, it means that canal has used navigated and power canal. Here I will explain. Now, a powerhouse is generated from here. Powerhouse. Here you have constructed a dam. Now, dam water is coming at this. And after the generation of electricity, the water again to go the river. Only the hydraulic pressure of the water is required. Clear? So this is irrigation canal. You have read carrier canal. Now you have feeder channel, feeder canal, navigation canal, and power canal. Now classification based on boundary. Surface of canal. So alluvial canal, non-alluvial canal, and reached boundary canal. My dear boy, what is alluvial? Actually, where a river is flowing, few river is coming on this. Okay. So in this area, the bank has been cut and the soil has come with the water pressure and they have deposited in a place like this area, this river, that they have deposited. And on that area, you want to make the alluvial canal. It is very risky. Alluvial soil is a decent soil for the cropping purpose. But alluvial canal is not so good. Non-alluvial canal, you can make this. A ridged boundary canal. Ridge boundary canal, when running like this, see this is the canal. This is the canal. So if water will be spread like this, here, right here. Up now, this is a ridge canal. The water pressurized here. So this is the rich canal. Now, classification based on discharge and its relative importance in a given network of the canal. So, my dear boy, at main canal, branch canal, major distributary, minor distributary, and water course. So, then what is the main canal? Is suppose a canal is coming like this. Up now it is the yes, it is the main canal. So now this canal is the branch canal. And from the branch canal, it is in past distributary. And from distributary, again, extended minor distributary. And then water course. So this is the given of canal detail. Now classification based on canal alignment. First contour canal, watershed canal, and side slope canal. Contour canal is made on a hilly area. Watershed canal is the top of earth, that is the ridge canal, and side slope canal is to be read. Someone, my dear boy, the canal is coming like this. From here, water has been stopped. So, if any nala are also running the corner of this canal, we have made cut and joined to this canal, and that is called side slope canal. Which is called side slope canal. So in diagram you can see better the detail of canal. Now canal alignment, of which is alignment. When we are planning the canal, a line has been dropped on the map, and up to the completion of map, we should retain on that. So now first it should be aligned a such way that the maximum area is served with the last length and its cost including 5D, work is minimum. Now, general consideration of arriving. A shorter length of canal has less loss of it due to friction, and smaller loss of water due to seepage and evaporation. So that additional area can be brought under cultivation. The alignment should be kept straight as for age prescribed. It will result in minimum losses. It should have minimum CD work. Now, a general consideration for alignment, and it should not pass through the village, town, forest, or costly land. Otherwise, heavily compensation shall have to give in. It should be such that heavy cutting and filling embankment are avoided. Now, general consideration for alignment. What is the general consideration of alignment? The alignment should be such that as far as possible, if landed, depth of cutting and filling is achieved. The alignment should not be made in rocky and brackish or cracked strata. Now, a canal section will be economical when earthwork involved at a particular section has an equal amount of the cut and fill. Usually, a canal section has a part in cutting and part in filling, as shown just. My dear boy, suppose a earth ground like this. Okay. And our position is this is the canal. 1 minute. Okay, so a canal section will be in economical when earth work involved at the particular section had to equal amount of cut and fill. So my dear boy, you see in the picture, this is cut. And this is cut, this is fill, this is fill, this is fill. And when it will be open, the water way coming in our river is open. So now this is the cutting and feeding material. So a canal will be economical when earthwork involved a particular section has an equal amount of cut outfield, usually a canal section has part in cutting and part in filling. Okay. If the amount of cut is equal to the amount of fill, so it had to be paid for once only. Definition for given of cross section. There is always only one depth of cutting for which the cutting and filling will be equal. The depth is known as the balancing depth. This is the balancing depth. This is called in technical language balancing depth. Now balancing depth h is equal to vertical height of top of bank from the bed of canal, d is equal to bed width of the channel, t is equal to top width of the canal bank, d1 is equal to side slope bank, finalize z ratio 1, side slope of canal is cutting, d is equal to full supply depth of the canal, y depth of cutting. So you see the formula of balancing depth. Now balancing depth, a canal is usually constructed with side slope of 1:1 and cutting in a slope 1:5. Side slope and cutting. What is the difference? Side slope and cutting. This is side slope 1:1. 1 meter here, 1 meter here. And which slope has developed this? This is called 1:1. And if this is 1, and this is 1.5, this is the side slope. So there is, you have seen two side slopes, 1:1 or 1:5. A canal is generally taken in such a way that its section is parted in cutting and partially filling in order to approach and also to balancing depth. So many times, however, the canal had to be carried throughout deep cutting or filling. So a canal structure may therefore either. In cutting, in filling and in partial cutting and filling. Now cross-section of canal. This is the cross-section of canal. This is the trapezoidal canal. And now this berm, and this is the canal bank. Now, component of canal, side slope, berm, freeboard, land width, dowla or dowel, a spoil bank, and borehole. Side slope, this is side slope. This canal is the side slope. Correct? And now, what is the berm? So, if this is the berm, now freeboard, a canal had design at the time, what is the depth? And we have adopted around 1 to 2 meter to free left for the freeboard. Freeboard means this water and this water. Here is no water, it will be empty. Okay. Why? Why? Because if need in future, so we can be increased. And this is the zone up. So, component of canal, side slope, berm, freeboard, land width, dowla, dowel, spoil bank, and borehole. Now, side slope, just I have explained, the side slope constructed on the both sides of the canal for along the water to flow in the between them, and as the canal it to be constructed in cutting and embankment or both. This is the side slope detail. Clay soil, this is side slope. Can sandy soil, loamy soil, gravel soil, hard rock and soft rock. Correct. Now, component of canal. This is the horizontal berm distance, which is the left at GL and ground level between the top edges of the cutting and toe of the bank whenever water wedge. So, in the canal at FSL, that FSL means full supply level, and silt practicals are deposited on the berm and make the final side slope of 1:1. Freeboard, just as we explained, it is the vertical distance between FSM and top of bank and it is provided to ensure that water does not overtop the bank and the magnitude of the freeboard in the channel are given by the consideration of the channel size and location and mean water inflow. An excellent soil characteristic is. So now this is your end of chapter. On this literature, on this material, I have prepared some MCQ and I want to ask with you how much you grasp from my lecture. So now, MCQ. Question number one, MCQ. A multi-purpose reservoir at the on which designed for one purpose but serves. What is the correct answer? The four answer is looking on your screen and which is the correct answer. Correct answer is B. Planned and constructed to serve various purposes. A rain gauge should preferably be fixed so correct answer is C in an open space. Now a repelling gion is aligned. Now, what is the correct answer? Correct answer is the pointing upstream. Now, a hand, a land is known as the water law. So, what will be replied? Which is correct answer? Correct answer, my dear boys. Capable fright to reach the root of zone of plant. A hydroelectric scheme operating under a head of 80 meter will the schedule as answer C. Okay. Weather conditions satisfied in higher head scheme. Now land of known next one is hydrograph is graphical representation of how much answer A rainfall intensity and three discharge and time. Now 70% index of wetness means the correct answer is B, a rain deficiency of 30%. Now next question, a current meter is used to measure where measure? Correct answer is A, velocity of flow of water. Now, a deep well is always deeper than the shallow well. So, it is the correct answer is A, sorry, B has more discharge than a shallow well. Now, last question. A divide wall is provided at the right angle, the axis at the weir, and correct answer is A, a divided wall is provided. And thank you very much for taking interest in my class. This is the reference book, and this is the name of author. Thank you very much. We will meet tomorrow.